logical AND gate. We write it as Q is equal to A dot B, read as A and B. This is the symbol. If you see the truth table, if any one of the inputs out of the two inputs is 0, then the output will be 0. In other words, output will be logic high only when each and every input is high. Logical OR gate. This is the symbol. Expression is Q is equal to A plus B, read as Q is equal to A or B. If we see the truth table, output is high if any one of the inputs out of the two inputs are high. Output is low only when both the inputs are low. If both the inputs are high or one of the inputs are high, then output will be high. Logical NAND gate. If you pass the output column or output of this AND gate through a NOT gate, that is, if you add a bubble here or if you add a NOT gate here, then you are going to get the truth table of NAND gate. AND plus NOT is NAND. Q, that's why you are adding a bar here. Q is equal to A dot B whole bar. If we see the truth table, output is low only when both the inputs are high. Exactly opposite to this. If any one of the inputs is low, then the output will be high. Logical NOR gate. A plus B whole bar. That is, we have to pass the output of OR gate through a NOT gate to get NOR. That is, OR plus NOT is NOR. This is the NOR gate symbol. Bubble indicates OR gate is followed by a NOT gate. If we see the truth table, output is high when both the inputs are zeros, else output is 0. If you see, it is exactly opposite of logic OR gate. When both the inputs are 0, then only output is high. If any one of the inputs is high, then the output will be low. Exclusive OR gate. A exclusive OR B, this is the symbol. The difference between the symbols of OR gate and XOR is, in OR gate only one curve is there like this at the input side. So in XOR gate, like this, two lines we have to draw at the input side of the curve. If we see the truth table, whenever the inputs are same, then output is 0. So if input is 0, 0 or 1, 1, that is, A is equal to B, then output is low. If the inputs are opposite, 0, 1 or 1, 0, then output is high. Hence, it is used in staircase switches. That is, we have a switch, one in the ground floor and one in the first floor. For the generally, it is used for the bulbs in the staircase. Either you can on at the bottom and off at the top, or you can use in the ground floor and also in the first floor, on and off operation. It is called anti-coincident detector, because whenever the inputs doesn't coincide, then output is high. Even parity generator, even parity checker circuit. If you see, one important useful property of XOR gate is, exclusive OR gate is, whenever any of the inputs is grounded, okay, then the XOR gate acts as a buffer, because whatever is the other input, it passes as it is to the output. Likewise, if any one of the inputs, say for example B, is connected to VCC permanently, connected to logic 1, connected to power supply, then this XOR gate acts as a NOT gate, because now one of the inputs is tied permanently to logic 1, only one input and one output, it acts as a NOT gate. Whatever input you give to the other terminal, it is negated and presented at the output. That is, XOR gates acts as a buffer if one of the inputs is grounded. XOR gates acts as a NOT gate if one of the inputs is tied to VCC or logic 1. XNOR gate, A exclusive OR B whole bar. If you pass the output of this XOR gate through a NOT gate, it is XNOR gate. So XOR plus NOT is XNOR, exclusive NOR. And hence the expression is Q is equal to A exclusive OR B whole bar. If we see the truth table, whenever the inputs are same, then the output is high. If inputs are not equal, then the output is 0. And hence it is called equivalence detector. Because whenever the inputs are equal, it is detecting and a high is presented at the output. It is also called as one bit digital comparator. So with this we can check whether the two bits are same or not. It is called coincidence detector because whenever the two inputs are coincide, then only one is produced at the output. It is called as odd parity checker and odd parity generator. In even parity bit scheme, the parity bit is 0 if there are even number of 1s in the data stream, and the parity bit is 1 if the odd number of 1s in the data stream. In odd parity bit scheme, the parity bit is 1 if there are even number of 1s in the data stream, and the parity bit is 0 if there are odd number of 1s in the data stream. Parity checker checks for possible errors in the transmission. When this circuit is used as even parity checker, the number of input bits must always be even. When a parity error occurs, the sum even output goes low and sum odd output goes high. If this logic circuit is used as an odd parity checker, the number of input bits should be odd, but if an error occurs, the sum odd should go low and the sum even output goes high. So even parity generator is an application of XOR gate. Even parity means the parity bit should be 0 if there are even number of 1s in the data stream. So in row 1, even number of 1s is there. 0 number of 1s means even number. In row 4 also even number of 1s is there. Then the parity bit is 0. Likewise, in row 2 and 3, odd number of 1s is there, then the parity bit is 1. So the output column is nothing but the even parity bit generator. Hence, XOR gate application is as even parity generator. Parity checker means it is a receiver circuit. Along with the generated parity bit and the two input bits, when applied, we can find whether data error has occurred in the data transmission or not. So XNOR gate is odd parity generator. Why? Because whenever there are even number of 1s, that is in row 1 and row 4, then the parity bit is 0. If there are even number of 1s, then the parity bit is 1, for example row 1 and row 4. If there are odd number of 1s, like in row 2 and row 3, then the parity bit is 0. So this is a 3 input XOR gate and 3 input XNOR gate truth table. For 3 input XOR gate, whenever odd number of 1s are present, then the output is 1. So in row 1, 0 1s are there, that is even number, so output is 0. In row 2, row 3, 1 bit 1 is there, odd number of 1s, so output is 1. Likewise, in row 4, even number of 1s are there, 2 1s are there, hence output is 0. So in 3 input XNOR gate, if even number of 1s are there, then output is 1. If odd number of 1s is there, for example in row 2 and row 3, then output is 0. NOT gate, whatever you give bit logic bit in here, inverted will appear at the output. Buffer means same will appear at the output. This is the truth table of all the gates at one place. AND gate, if you type both the inputs together, it can act as a buffer. Or if you connect one of the inputs to VCC, it also acts as a buffer. Likewise, OR gate, it acts as a buffer if you connect both the inputs to a single input. Or if you connect one of the input to ground, then it also acts as a buffer.